So in this problem, guys, means we will find a pair with a given sum. Okay, so the problem is we have to find a pair in an array. Pair means we have to find two elements whose sum is equal to any target value. Like we have right now sum. Okay, so we have to find a pair. If we found the pair, we have to print that pair, else means we can give message not found. Okay, so we can enhance this problem to means we can find multiple pairs also in this array, right? The problem can also be make like count the number of pairs we have in an array, right? So what approach I will follow? So you can use that approach in both the cases, to count the number of pairs and to count the one pair also. Okay, so the pair means I'm saying like this, means in an array, means this is the dummy data I put in an array. Okay, so this is a normal array initialization. Okay, so here the pair means 4, 6 are the two elements whose sum is equal to this variable. Okay, and we have another pair also, 5, 5, right? So we can take both the pairs, but in this problem we have to take only one pair. So if the interviewer asks you to count the number of pairs we have, so then you can store the number of pairs, which you can store in a list, and after that you can print the list size, right? For this one, firstly, I will follow the brute force.
Best of four lots, I will iterate over all the elements. Okay, so firstly I will take the first element and I will check with all the rest of the elements if we have a pair which is equal to this sum. Okay, and similarly for the second index I will check all the other elements.
Okay, so here this is the nested loop. Okay, so I have written, and the inner loop is I've just started from i+1, because we don't need to start this loop from the starting point, right? Because we have already checked that elements. So for this approach, the time complexity we will get is n square. Okay, so firstly the inner loop is running n times, after that n-1 times, n-2, so this will become the AP series, right? And so like this is a sum formula of AP, and we have to get the upper bound, right? So which is n square. So this is a time complexity, right? So in this just I will put the condition here. I will check is if any pair which is equal to that sum. Okay, if we have, then this I have created these two variables. I will store here, and this pair one is equal to array dot I, right? Pair two j, and after that I can just using this boolean flag so that I can print if we found the variable, if we found the pair or not, right? So I'm just breaking if I found the one pair. Okay, so after that I've just put a condition, if flag is true we have found that pair, right? So I'm just printing that pair, and if it's not, then I will print the not found. Okay, so now I'm just running the program. Yeah, you can see it's printing 5, 5. Okay, so this is the brute force approach. Okay, so but we have other best approaches also. We can use the sorting, right? By sorting we have a different sorting algorithms, right? Quick sort we can use, whose time complexity is n log n, right? So which is better than this brute force, right? So okay, so for that one what I can do is then I need a two pointers. Okay, so I iterate over array, which I will use left pointer which is at 0th position and right pointer which is at last position. okay. So length is a size and I'm just decrementing one so that an area you can point. So I will start a while loop. Left should be less than right. Okay. And if I'm just checking if left plus right sum is equal to that sum, then I can straightway misbreak the loop. And I will store this data in a pair of variables, right? Not I here, we have a left, here we have a right, and I can break, right? And the same way I will use the flag. Okay, so this is the condition if we found that pair. Okay, so but we have to iterate again, means if we don't find the right, we need to increment the left pointer, decrement the right pointer. Okay, so if the this pair sum is greater than this, okay, then what we will do is we will decrement the right pointer because value is already greater, right? So and array, add one thing we forgot here, we need to sort the array, right? So I'm using the inbuilt function arrays.sort and this will sort the array. Yeah, the important thing we forgot to sort, and I've sorted, and here in else is if the sum is lesser than I can increment the left pointer. I think it should work by using this logic. The same way means here I'm doing the flag. Yeah, you can see 4, 6 we found the pair. Okay. So this is the second approach. Okay. But still for this problem is I can again optimize both. I can solve this problem in a big of n time. Then what I need to do is I don't need these left right pointers, I don't need this sorting. So that I can do by using hash map. Okay. Hash map or hash set I can use, right? If you need to store the indexes, then you can use the hash map because in the values you can use that. You can store the indexes. Hash set. Just importing the class. And here we need to store the data in a hash map. We already have a length variable. Okay. Actually, hash set internally using the hash map only, so that's why I'm saying the hash map. Okay. So here means I've added all the values, and in this loop I will check this if we have a pair or not. Okay. If set contains some minus, if a value is then there, then I'm just checking the other pair in a set. If we have, then I can store its value, right? Okay, this one I have to So here means I'm storing the other pair. Okay, and the same way you making the flag true and breaking the loop, you can see it will give you the result. You can say false. So this one is a better solution because we are using only a single loop for iterating, and actually it's taking the extra space, but is a more optimized solution. And if you have to count the number of pairs, then instead of using these pairs, you can use the list, and in inside list like this. So you have to store the two pairs, right? So you can use the array, integer array list like this. You can declare the list, and in inside list you can add these pairs whatever you are finding. Here is these pairs you can put in the list, and after that you can return the list size if you want the count, or you can print the pairs, right? So guys, do let me know if you have any queries, any suggestions. Do subscribe my channel. Thanks.